And then I reach in his chest and I rip out his heart and I throw it down into the ground and I'm like, that's why, Dad.
Yeah.
We will continue that later. Hi, everyone. My name's Stephen Pope and welcome to Mask, A New Generation. I brought an iPad just so you guys can actually see. Yes, there's a book. You can buy it.
It's actually really gorgeous, yeah.
It's a really pretty book. I'm waiting for them to do a print-on-demand version. Also, we have pugs now.
Yeah.
Immediately better than whatever you were going to do today, because we have pugs. Look at them. Also, our producer, we have two producers today. Sax, who seems to be toddling off to go do Phoenix Dawn Command things, and Wolfman, so. That was him whistling, if you heard that. All right. So, once again, welcome to Mask, a teenage superhero angsty RPG. We spent an entire session on someone's first kiss last week. It was actually pretty awesome. I'm your host, Stephen Pope. This is Wonder Pug, who will be playing Atlas Pug. And to my left, eating Chick-fil-A today of all days.
Chick-fil-A stopped their donations 5 years ago, all right? We have to forgive. As a nation.
I'll forgive nothing, ever. You can't make me.
And then that guy died. And then he died. All right?
Well, it's amazing what a diet of hatred and fried chicken will do to a body, yeah. Right?
Oh, like, my God.
Okay.
Clip that.
Hi. My name is Jordan, and I am playing the character Swole, who is the grotesquely over-muscled strong man who can also shapeshift in a vague sort of sense. He spent a lot of last session as a boat.
It's horrible.
And he has Atlas the Pug as his companion dog, which is his new ability he got recently. So that's Swole.
And ordering Chinese food.
Ordered Chinese food. It
what?
Is ordered and on its way. Hi, I'm Jack. I just came from the protest downtown, so I'm
yay!
Covered in glitter. And I'm starving. I play Charlie Malinowski, who is Buckshot. He's the Legacy, and he is like a metal elemental. And the Legacy also, like, there's like a suite of skills, and they have determined, and by they I mean Michael, has determined that I have the Batman suite, minus...
Right, the suite of the Batman suite, Mr. Malinowski.
minus the intimidation.
There, right?
So... He's just my sweet, sweet, sweet...
Little gay boy.
Gay boy.
Yes.
He's adorable, and I love him.
So. And moving to Nicole. Oh, wait.
Oh, wait. Shit.
I'm Nicole. Yeah. you can catch me... shit. We love you, Nicole. We do miss you. But I also have the entire side of the table to myself.
Can really man spread.
And enjoying his man spread.
Yes. Today, the part of Kid Stardust will be played by Man Spread. No, I'm Michael Holmes. I'm social media manager at Geek and Sundry. If you're watching this live today on Saturday, January 21st, 2017, get out there, make your voices heard, and get home safe.
Woo!
I'm playing Kid Stardust, the Nova, who is kind of the Captain Marvel or Nova from Marvel or Green Lantern, kind of flying energy slinger. She is a 17-year-old genderqueer, pink mohawked David Bowie fan.
Yeah, she is. With some family issues to work out.
Just a few.
All right. So last week, we had some moments, for lack of a better term. Someone
they
got a dog.
Great.
Someone got
dog.
Their... So, oh, right, influence. Don't forget to spread out your influence.
Yeah. I think just Nicole had influence over me.
I think... No.
No.
You did at some point.
I thought I did still.
Well, yeah.
No.
I think you
yeah,
did.
Yeah, no.
I feel like something happened, but we gained it back.
Yeah.
I feel like the team is fully influenced on each other right now.
Right.
Except he still does not have influence, or I don't
right.
have influence over him.
Because right. hashtag bully.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm.
What was I saying?
I denied it at some point, right?
I think you were about to give a recap of the show.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
Right. So, last week, after being attacked by some rando cultist, brought to you by our Patreon, by the way, if you are a backer, you are officially a mob boss superhero supervillain in the city. Hit us up in the chat for that information and on Patreon for that. You guys were attacked by cultists while you were going to go meet your, while Kid Stardust here was going to go meet her girlfriend's parents for the first time.
Mm-hmm. She was dressed very nicely.
Yeah, very nicely. And shit got weird, and there was yelling and hurt feelings.
Shit got great. Like, it was great. It was a great session.
I didn't say it was a bad session. I'm just saying, like, you were fighting cultists, and shit got real.
It's going down for real.
Please, someone gift that. Please, someone gift that. I want that to be our new, like, you backed us. Here's a gift. Michael Whiteman dancing.
Yeah. Anyway, sorry, go on.
So, after a really, really awkward blow up, Buckshot found his mentor stabbed by none other than Feo, the rogue water elemental who's gone mad. Why? We're not entirely sure yet. So, you guys all met up, and Feo started flooding the Strip, aka District 10, on our handy-dandy map, which I hope was updated. So, you guys went to her fortress, a castle in the sky, if you will.
Castle on a cloud?
Castle on a cloud.
I like to go there in my sleep.
There you go. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Les Mis, we go there. And Swole, last time we saw you, you had just tackled Feo and fallen off the edge of the building.
Right.
The flying castle in a cloud, if you will.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. So we're going to start off with you.
So
that makes
I fall.
Everyone.
That's what
also,
I do next.
If memory serves, the stinger was that it started to crumble around us.
Yes, it did.
Yes. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So, Swole, you are plummeting towards the water very fast. You're going to do a cannonball that might cause another flood. We'll just make that perfectly clear. But I have a question for you. What are you scared of most? Because you have, because you're still holding on to Feo, and she's crackling with green energy, and her eyes are a
what am I scared
shade.
Of in, like, life, or what am I scared of in this
what,
particular well, situation?
What are you scared of?
Like, in general.
What are you scared of?
Swole does not like small, confined spaces, and he doesn't like the idea of, like, being laughed at all the time.
Okay.
Not like, he doesn't mind, like playing at himself, but he doesn't like the idea of, like, being a like, thing of, like, he would not like tabloids that are, like, the weird guy doing shit, you know?
So, with that information, I take it a small, cramped cage lined with National Enquirer magazines all about you while you're somewhere in your 40s and realizing you're still like this.
Yeah, you probably wouldn't like that.
Yeah, that's immediately where you land when you fall in the water. Headphones! Jordan, I'm a little hungover.
Hey, you put me there!
If you're scaring the straights!
If you didn't see that coming, come on.
Straights.
This show is brought to you by boobs, the solution to and the cause of all of life's problems.
Ding!
My enchilada.
Thanks for that, Wolfman. Mm-hmm. All right. So, I'm gonna go ahead and let you roll real quick to see if you can, like, center yourself. Because you fell off a building, landed in the water, and now you're in a cage.
All right, that's pretty crazy.
9.
Okay.
Plus
9, anything? And am I rolling with anything, or?
No, right. Unless you have conditions.
Well, it's 9. 9 is great. No, I don't think I do at this point.
I don't think you do either. I don't think any of us do. Mm-mm.
I think somehow we all got our conditions.
How the hell?
Actually, I think I have angry marked here, but I don't remember if I still had that. But I think I do, because
that's
I think I got it.
That's the post-its.
Yeah.
Post-its.
I think I got it when we were fighting.
Mass brought to you by Manspread, post-its, and
Chinese food.
Yeah.
And Chinese food.
And Chinese food.
Yeah. Okay, so I think I have angry.
Okay, I'll go ahead and add that to your roll.
Okay.
So you're at 10. You have the mental fortitude to realize this doesn't make sense. Also, you realize you're not holding Feo anymore, but you do feel yourself de-age back to, like, your proper 18. How old are you?
Yeah.
18-year-old self.
I think I'm 19, actually.
19-year-old self, then.
Right.
But you're still in a cage. And for some reason, everything is kind of crackling green around you.
Okay, so since I have the sense that this is, like, either not right or not real or, like, it doesn't make a lot of sense, I think I'm just going to kind of like Hulk out and just try and like push out in every direction as hard as I can. See if I can get.
Go ahead and attack.
Okay.
Roll an attack for me real quick.
Attack! It's not a great attack.
That is a three.
It's a three.
A three. Yes, if you will.
With danger is 4-5, so.
Still fail.
Still a failure. Yeah, go ahead, failure. Mark potential.
Can someone pass me a
console? Can I? Do you want, no, that's okay.
It'll do.
Okay. That will.
Would I?
Peg leg.
All right.
Peg leg.
Or hair lip, depending on
the ones I can choose.
Fair enough.
What you've heard.
Hair lip.
Wooden
pass
legs.
Me two of those. I still have two rerolls.
Oh, right. You'd have two rerolls.
Oh, I have one.
I have four. Good lord.
We gotta use these rerolls.
I'm saving them for something. God.
And do we have any team?
Yes.
You guys were sitting at two team.
Okay, cool.
I'll go ahead.
Not three team, because we have.
I thought one of you.
I think we used something up.
We did.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I just wanted to double check.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay.
You start fighting, and the cage seems to shrink, and you hear the voice of a teenage girl go, "I can't let you do that." So, on top of a giant crumbling tower in the sky, real quick.
Right, so who's there? It's us three.
It's you three and Lifesaver.
Am I still falling by the cage, or is the cage like suspended?
You can't that tell dude. Anymore.
Lifesaver, our misogynistic Aquaman analog.
David Hasselhoff,
awkward.
Baby Boomer.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Definitely votes Republican.
Pretty terrible.
He's kind of garbage.
Come on, Kid Star, let's just give him a chance.
How do you know you're a lesbian? Have you ever been with a guy? I hate Thanksgiving.
Hashtag Hoff. Okay, anyway, go on. Okay, so how rapidly is it crumbling around?
Oh, this? It is falling the fuck apart.
Okay, I'm going to charge my powers or attempt to charge my powers because I've got an idea.
All right.
That's a 9 plus conditions,
nice.
So I don't have any. So it's...
And can we take a second just to appreciate your Doctor Who dice, which are awesome?
Oh, but I do have to mark a condition now.
Okay.
But I get to hold 3 burn, so awesome. I'm going to say I'm afraid.
Makes sense.
And 3 burn. So she is overcharging her powers, and she kind of starts crackling with this pink and black energy that radiates from her eyes and tries to extend this huge bubble around the castle just to prevent us from falling and it debris falling on other people. But I believe that would involve me trying to unleash my powers, which will be on my next turn.
I'll let you do it right now.
Yeah? Okay.
If you want to unleash your powers.
I do. Overcharge is automatically a 10.
Okay.
Plus Freak, which is a 12.
Nice.
So that's a thing.
That's a thing.
Maybe in just a tiny little trickle of blood coming from the nose, a little homage to 11. You know, she's yeah. really pushing herself.
Oh, you know I'm going to be using that one later.
Sure, of course.
Thank you for that gift.
Hashtag radiation.
Hashtag radiation. So, the castle.
Hovering just, you know, a couple inches off the ground, all Akira style.
Is your hair just kind of awesome.
Yeah.
So the castle, which is kind of shaped like an hourglass, but from the bottom looks like a birdcage, it slowly starts riding itself up because of your force field. Things are still falling off it, but they're kind of like hitting the bottom of it and just staying there.
Mm-hmm.
It's also, you know this before anyone else, it's starting to melt.
Mm-hmm.
So what do you do?
That's a good question.
Also, you saw Swole fall off the side of the building, and you're somewhere over the lost city of Kaganistan. Wink.
Oh, God, I don't remember what happened in there.
Well,
that was the whole big, like, that was the sunken...
Yeah, with the god of death and all of that.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah.
Somebody who might or might not have been the god of death.
Yeah. Oh, God. I'm just like, oh, that would be unleashing powers for sure. Fuck. I have an idea, but it's like so
please
impossible.
Do it.
Just playing a superhero fantasy role-playing game.
I mean. Know, but it's like, okay.
And I've been reading a lot of Neil Gaiman, so frankly, I'm up for anything. I don't care anymore. Trump's president. I don't have to give a shit about life anymore.
Yeah,
let's
nothing.
Go.
Yeah, I didn't give a shit to begin with.
Worst dystopian RPG ever, by the way.
Yeah, did not.
I don't want to pull a Sean, miss you, buddy, but like, I'm very proud of all the protesters today.
Oh, me too.
I'm very proud of them.
Yeah.
You're welcome.
Thank you. I love. There's actually an impromptu one going on in North Hollywood right now.
Great.
This makes me so
happy. Yeah, because they're people that can't get through on the metro.
I know.
It's bananas.
Colin, CJ Greens, who will be on Maximum Miniatures, wanted to go this morning.
Yeah.
Couldn't get on the train.
We ended up parking at like a valet lot and then walking half an hour to get to the protest.
This sounds terrible, but I wish I owned a parking lot downtown today.
Yeah. It was.
They made so much money.
Oh yeah. Oh, they jacked. There was
and
one.
Said, yeah.
Jacked
and who said protests are bad for the
bucks.
Economy? Mm-hmm. Anyway.
Yeah. So you're falling over.
He's already fallen. He's outside of the sphere.
You're okay. He basically fell on the other side of this giant Die Hard-esque roof situation.
You became a motherfucker.
Okay.
I try and reach for a gun behind my back, but I don't have that sort of
I wonder
skill.
If there's
a gun. And by the way, just to make our audience comfortable, Atlas Pug is currently with Charlie.
Yay.
I like to imagine he let out kind of a baleful
like a pug bark, yeah. Obviously. They have a weird kind of bark to it.
It's not less of a bark, more of a borf.
So
high quality content.
Would it hurt you more to fall in the water or fall on something before hitting the water?
I don't know what my body can recover from.
Okay.
that is not a limit I have
okay.
tried.
So let's try this limit. let's test it, why not? This is also great because I'm going to basically unleash my powers. I'm gonna try to lift something up from the lost city of Kyganistan to protect Swole from hitting the water.
Okay. What are you going to lift up? There are a lot of towers down there.
I know. Is there some sort of satellite dish or something? Or the roof of a building or
there is both those things are definitely down there.
Okay, I wanna do a satellite dish.
Okay, I mean, yeah. It was kind of like a scientist idea, a bit of a Limetown situation, so.
What? God, so good. Oh, it's such a good podcast.
Yeah, it was this short-lived podcast about this scientific community that just vanished in 2008.
Oh, it's Ooh. So
It's
good.
Really good.
10 episodes.
We're not we're not doing plugs yet.
No, right, sorry.
It was so fucking good.
It was really good. I was kind of want another season, but we'll see.
Oh, so good. Yeah, so I'm going to try that, I guess.
All right, you are reshaping your environment, and that is definitely...
Unleashing your powers.
Unleash. Freak out.
And I have two rerolls, which
Unleash.
Is...
That is...
An 8, because I have a -1 for freak. But I will take it. Marking condition, or the GM will tell you how the effect is unstable or temporary.
Which would you like?
I will mark a condition.
Okay.
I will feel... you know what, because of that, I'm going to feel hopeless because it just, it still doesn't feel like I'm doing enough. And it also affects unleashing your powers.
All right.
So it makes sense to me.
Okay.
Because I don't understand why I'd be angry, afraid, guilty, or insecure.
Well, you're always a little
Actually,
insecure, but.
No, insecure would make sense because we're in an area that there isn't a whole lot of stuff for me to work with.
That's fair.
So never mind.
So you're going with insecure instead of hopeless?
Yes.
And chaos lad is still reeling from having kissed my sister.
Actually, no. Hopeless would still work.
Sure.
You gotta pick one.
I'm keeping hopeless.
All right.
It's the end of that.
So, Swole, you feel your cage shatter, and then you feel yourself thrusted upwards. You still can't see where you are, though. Everything's kind of like this green mist surrounding you. You guys see as you focus really hard, you're floating, nose bleeding, 11-ing. Jack.
Yes.
Buckshot.
Yes.
You pull up the satellite, it catches him and flings him back onto the top of the castle, we'll call it.
Yeah.
He lands with a thud and kind of rocks the boat. I mean,
okay.
I assume he can get through your force field, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Don't ask me the science of it, but yes.
Science, it's fantastic.
Yes.
And Swole is, you aren't, he's not holding Feo. And he's crackling green and his eyes are green.
Oh, son of a bitch.
Ah!
In front of you is, now Swole, in front of you is, looks like one, two, we'll go ahead and, what was the term sex used for someone who's missing? Jaeger?
Jaeger, yeah.
One, two, three, well, Jaeger, Nicole in the situation. Four Devereaux's.
Ah! More than one of you! So I'm just going to do what comes natural and barrel at the first one that's closest to me.
And who would that be?
Yeah, take your pick, buddy.
I don't know. I don't know where the, how this world's laid
who's
out.
Who's he running for?
Okay, chat, like, we'll and do...
Actually, while we're paused for that, what does meat arm mean?
Meat hand?
Meat hand, yes.
It's somebody who is very talented at welding.
And then...
Golden arm. Oh, God, you're gonna make me look it up.
I mean, okay.
Meat hand is what cyborgs call all regular people.
Well,
nobody loves you because you're tiny and made of meat.
Look at your hands.
I wish that I was joking. All I typed in for Google was like welding slang, and then I clicked the first thing that came up.
I'm glad to know real thought went into meat hand.
I kind of feel like
okay, so.
I know exactly what I'm doing with this character, by the way. But
so, okay, so here are the legit terms. So, golden arm is a welder with excellent technique and end results. Meat hand, derived from the term bead hand, a root pass welder on a pipeline job. Usually a good welder that can run slick root passes, stringer beads, in X-ray pipelines in production mode. A bunch of words that make no fucking sense to me, but I thought it was a great name for a superhero.
You're saying a bunch of words that I know, but in sequence they make no sense.
Yeah, there's no context to it.
There was another one that was called If Golden Arm Had Like a Sidekick. It was their name was gonna be Bugger because that's a welder's helper cleaning up and prepping weld in advance.
Bugger.
Drinking hand, welder that drinks alcohol in excess, not necessarily a bad connotation.
We don't talk about him, all right? He's in a program.
No.
The one that I personally love is Potato Face, a welder with flash-burned eyes.
Wow!
Yeah, so...
Wolfman has a chat made a decision.
And buckshot means welding spatter.
Yes. So. I think it's better... that you called your little gay boy welder superhero Buckshot and not Bugger.
Yeah.
You're welcome.
That would have had slightly different connotations.
GM, number the targets 1 to 4.
Okay.
In your head. The majority of the chat is 3, 2.5 pi, and 2 to the power of 1.6.
You dicks.
So,
way to be on brand, kids.
We're in the neighborhood of 3, whatever that means to you, GM.
So, Kid Stardust.
All
right. I was actually bracing myself for me. I was
no,
like,
no, here's how I did it. 1, 2, 3, 4.
God, you're such a...
How am I a dick?
I didn't even finish the sentence. I was going to say
I'm very used to being
you're
called
so
a dick by you.
Simple.
I'm also
no,
playing
that's my
this
name
as,
for Jordan.
As though that there's like kind of a mind control element to the whole thing. I think, like, if I really saw 4 Gregor Devereaux's, I would kind of be like, hey, why are there 4 of you?
Yeah, but funny how that works out, isn't it?
I think in this case, like, I would be like, nope, fuck this. We're in the middle of a battle with the Green Inferno. There's some shit going on. He's you know, here. I got to attack him.
Yep.
So I am going to barrel at Kid Devereaux.
Kid D.
And that will be Bucky, rap name.
Bucky D, KD, Aqua D.
Oh, that is a 12.
Shall I roll to take a powerful blow?
Well, first he gets the pick, and then you'll roll for that.
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, boy. I don't like this.
I love it.
You passed the JoJo's.
Yes.
Yes, yes. To the JoJo's.
Thanks.
I'm really happy with that puppy.
I'm not gonna lie, you holding a dog is kind of adorable.
You should see me holding cats.
Okay.
I like how you match
blows. So wait, we do trade blows, just because I hit, right?
You choose not to. Go ahead and read the options.
It says, when you directly engage a threat, roll plus danger. On a hit, trade blows. On a plus 10, pick 2. On a 7 to 9, pick 1.
Right.
So I think we still trade blows no matter what.
No, your options are resistant. Exactly. Resist their blows. And that can mean
but then
you
there's
dodge
nothing,
them.
There's no opportunity to hit them in this, though.
Well, you definitely hit her.
Right, okay. I'm going to, I don't feel like I have any allies in this world of Devros. So I'm going to resist or avoid their blows, and I am going to impress, surprise, or frighten the opposition.
Go ahead and mark afraid.
I'm already afraid.
Okay, mark a condition of your choice then.
Angry.
And roll to take powerful blow. You are at a negative one.
So that is... That's a 10, is what that is.
please read to the audience what happens when you roll a 10.
All right, so take a powerful blow, roll plus conditions marked. On a 10 plus, choose one. You must remove yourself from the situation, flee, pass out, etc. You lose control of yourself or your powers in a terrible way. Or choose two options from the 7 to 9 list. So I'll read the 7 to 9 list. You lash out verbally, provoke a teammate to foolhardy action or take advantage, blah, blah, blah. You give ground. Your opposition gets an opportunity. You struggle past the pain. Mark two conditions. As soon as you kind of knock her down or whatever, she loses concentration of the bubble that's been holding the castle together and it dissipates.
Oh, that's happening.
And the castle begins to crumble again.
Classic.
Yes. So that's happening.
Awesome. That's a world we're living in. Sounds wonderful. So thrilled. So thrilled for this.
So,
right now.
I'll just go ahead and use this as an example. Mm-hmm. So when it started falling apart, it kind of went like this, but then you bubbled it, so it had a nice, like, balancing going on. Mm-hmm. But thanks to you running around it and you losing control, it's currently at a nice 45 degree angle.
Solid.
So we're all Joseph Gordon-Levitt in Inception at this point?
Yeah.
Pretty much, except gravity's still here and it's a bitch.
Sure.
Question.
Answer.
So because Atlas is Swole's dog, but Swole is batshit right now, who does Atlas take orders from?
He still takes control from, he takes orders from Swole. Stuff.
Oh, so he's not with me, sort
well,
of.
Well, no, you're holding him because it's a pug and otherwise it'd be very dead.
Okay, and I'm adorable. So.
Yes, very much
he's
so.
He's so cute.
I don't perceive Atlas as being with me right now,
no.
I don't think, so.
You do not. Otherwise, you'd have like a mini like Invasion of the Body Snatchers 1970s Devereaux head on a dog body thing, and no one needs that. I'm a good Christian girl, I pay my taxes, I don't need that. So
what? You're
that's true.
None of that. Like
I do pay my taxes.
I was gonna say, I can't speak to the taxes thing.
I do pay my taxes.
Cheerfully withdrawn.
Steven especially says that in case anybody from the IRS is watching.
Braid.
No, Braid.
I'm kidding.
Is that what
I
do?
I don't know why I threw that on you, Braid.
Audit. They would audit him, which is about the same thing, and it would make Steven's anxiety go higher than it already is.
I already blew out a tire on the 405. I've had a. Trump's in office. I've had a week.
You've had 2 days.
All right.
Shit was happening before then.
What's going on now?
So, you feel yourself lurch forward, but you manage to hold on to the ground. One of the Devereaux's you punch, Actually, what did you pick for your...
Well, that I lose control of yourself or powers in a terrible way. This feels pretty terrible.
I'm going to go ahead and add to it, though, because I'm kind of a monster today. You're glowing.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
Not in a good way.
No, yeah.
Yeah.
Stop. Collaborate.
We'll listen. Get there.
I love
okay,
it.
Okay, Charlie. So you're flung off your feet, and you land.
Everybody's glowing green.
You're not glowing.
I know, not me, but I don't like this.
No, Atlas, yeah, not Atlas. Shrug, Swole.
Oh my god.
Fuck off. Swole doesn't seem to... You were there when the cataclysm occurred.
Yes.
Swole obviously isn't here right now.
Hold on. Alhambra is calling me.
The whole city?
Well, fuck.
Hello?
Let's all listen in.
What?
What?
They want to talk to me about my restaurant order.
Oh.
Hold on, I ordered food.
Also, Braid, I was accusing you of being an IRS agent.
Hi, you have a delivery for me?
He was accusing you of being a narc, though.
Yeah. No.
Yeah, are you at the front door?
She's a narc.
Okay, I'll be down in just a second.
Keeps the channel from exploding.
Thanks.
So we take a break now for Chinese food.
So now let's talk about Limetown. Tell me about Limetown.
I guess we're doing plugs right now. We are.
We can do plugs whenever.
We're 30 minutes into the show. We're doing plugs. I'm having a. This is a great game. This is great. Yeah. So Limetown is a podcast in the vein of Serial or Black Tapes or Tannis, which I highly recommend all of those. Mm-hmm. And the setup is a girl lost her uncle in Limetown in 2008. Now Limetown was this.
Oh, so this is real.
It's fiction.
Okay.
But they do a really good job of presenting it as real, so mazel tov on that. So in Limetown, girl lost her uncle, and she's putting together this sort of essay thing. And after she goes and visits Limetown and looks like it's over, she gets a message from someone who claims to be a survivor of Limetown. And it involves conspiracies and mind reading and a bunch of cool stuff. It's like 6 hours of your life well spent.
I'm into it.
Yeah. And I'm really waiting on that season two. Give it. I also finished Tannis season two, so now I have nothing except for Adventure Zone.
After last week's game, I shared a link with Jordan for a podcast called Imaginary Worlds, I think.
Uh-huh.
And what it is it's imagine if Night Vale and This American Life had a baby, because they talk about real life things, but then they put kind of this fantastic sheen over them.
What is it?
So, it's called Imaginary Worlds. So the episode that I shared with Jordan was all about H.P. Lovecraft, and it's about this guy who goes to like Red Hook and Providence and is talking to all these people. And all the interviews start off as like legit, and then they're like, "And you know that it was real, right?" And he's like, "Wait, what?" And one of the things that I really liked about it is that they also talk about what a kook and an inveterate racist he was,
which he was.
They didn't, you know, try and gloss over that. But yeah, it was a really entertaining story, I felt.
Yeah, I only listened to the beginning of it, but I need to.
Well, you should listen to it all the way through, because it gets good.
I fully intend on listening to that. Ooh, you got bao.
Mm-hmm.
Yum.
And fried rice.
All right. Back to masking.
Yeah.
Back to masking.
Masks.
Miskatonic. Okay, Drag.
Mm-hmm.
So you're knocked off your feet. Atlas makes an adorable, like, squeaky toy noise when you land.
Mm-hmm.
Swole is obviously not here. What do you do? Also, Kid Stardust is glowing pink. And Kevin, who will just... I'm not going to do a Nicole impersonation. I can't do it, right?
I feel like he's just screaming.
There's a lot of screaming and clinging on to stuff. And Lifesaver is already kind of barreling towards the edge.
The fuck, man?
I know. It's like I'm trying to keep this interesting.
He's a water elemental. Like, why can't he keep his shit together?
Well, I still have to imagine that if he... I will actually... contact with the water from the height that we're at, it's not going to feel great.
No, I'm also going to go ahead and add that you're well aware that Lifesaver was mostly a product of good PR. As far as elementals go, dude's kind of shit tier.
Mm-hmm. That's probably true.
Casual Lullaby, thank you, Max, has donated one of many, which is one of the many flares you can purchase through our donations tab. Meaning, Buckshot, you receive aid from another elemental. Mm. And you also, let me go double check. I think you get advantage on your next roll as well.
Oh, cool.
Let's see. One of many, out of nowhere, another elemental arrives to help, turns the table. You mark potential, and you get to name the elemental.
Mmm.
Those look so much better than the depression burrito I had earlier.
Quick question, Steven.
Yes?
Going back to when I took the powerful blow, would that technically count as a failure?
No, it's a failure if you roll like regular.
Yeah, no. You succeeded with flying colors, my friend.
Great.
Yeah.
I'm just eager to check out this last box of potential. That's all. Go on.
It's fine, buddy.
I think I'm gonna do an air elemental.
Okay. And what is their name?
Their name is Litho.
Litho.
For Lithosphere.
Okay. Someone hand me a pencil. I need to start keeping like a catalog of all the elementals.
I know, there's a lot of them. We have a convention every year.
I know. Well, Hyperion City is Rumspringa for aliens, and Salt Lake City for...
What's the convention call, Jack?
Lithosphere would be the stone.
It's just, it's Elecon. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we rent out like a Hyatt.
So we have Ash and Ember.
We get like we get block rooms.
Sure. Karaoke night.
Yeah, oh yeah, for sure. God, you'd be crazy if you didn't have a karaoke night.
Right.
Is that happening at Gen Con? I hope that happens at Gen Con.
Okay. Just a heads up, litho means stone.
Does it? Mm. Even though lithosphere?
Lithosphere is the stone pre-mantle.
Oh.
Is I didn't know that.
I thought it was
science.
No, it's not litho.
Monolith.
Oh. Yeah. Then no, that's not what
I feel really dumb
is.
Now.
All right, Smarty Pants, where does lithograph come from?
Because the...
Ooh.
Chat, look that up. Let us know.
No.
I'm looking it up.
Fuck it. Their name is Breeze.
Breeze.
Super easy. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And he's gayer than I am, so it's pretty fun. Well,
it's a method of printing originally based on the immiscibility of oil and water. The painting is from a stone or metal plate with a smooth surface.
I'm putting mine away. I was just literally waiting for my food to get here.
Yeah.
Oh, you're fine.
I'm even gonna grow a tree. Watch this. I can't even use it. My tree's gonna die. So,
what the
suck
hell?
It, Steven. I win. It's an app called Forest. So this is also my plug. It's an app called Forest. What it does is it, on the dice cam?
Dice cam. They can't see it otherwise.
So it locks your screen. So if you click away from it, it'll kill the tree that you're growing, and you won't get the points for it. So I even have to gamify, like, not touching my phone. But on the plus side, if you get 2,500, if you get 2,500 points, they will actually plant a real tree.
Oh, that's nice.
In an area that needs trees.
Hardcore mode. If you touch your phone before that tree is done growing, they actually cut down a tree.
Yeah.
Why? Yes. They're already doing that even if I don't touch my... Like, if I do touch my ground,
they cut down a tree. Extra tree.
They go out, and they find a beautiful old oak, and they just, like, destroy it.
I see a tree with a gun to its head.
Yeah.
Buy this magazine!
There's a lumberjack with an axe who doesn't want to cut this tree down, and they're like, please don't touch it!
There's two ways we can do this. Which one do you want?
You know how much I love lumberjacks.
And the lumberjack is just sobbing.
Yes. Jack/lumberjack OTP. Now,
Breeze.
Mm-hmm. Breeze.
He's like blonde, blue eyes, like just like tall, lanky. Like hyper gay.
So
just like annoying.
Buckshot. You lose your footing. You lose whatever. It's a very flat surface. It's basically like standing on glass anyway. So you are just sliding towards what seems like your death.
Mm-hmm.
And you find yourself landing in nice toned muscle arms.
Oh, I hate it.
And staring down at you is a pair of beautiful blue eyes with blonde hair that's expertly coiffed.
He's so annoying though. Like, he's so annoying. He's the worst person. I'm like, oh, what are you doing here?
Hey, beauty girl.
Oh, secrets? God.
What'd you call him?
Beauty girl.
He hits on me all the time. It's so uncomfortable.
In all fairness, he hits on everyone all the time.
Mm-hmm.
Even Stardust has a weird little tingle for him.
Ugh.
Hmm?
Even Stardust has a weird little tingle for him.
Yeah. He's just annoying.
Just because he is so, you know.
He walks the line.
He is so what he is.
He is
she loves
very much what he is.
Only villains hit on Swole, and that's in the literal
Oh, no,
sense.
He's hit on No, he's hit on you.
Mm-hmm. You just may not have noticed.
Yeah, I'm surprised I've met this person.
Yeah, why not? We'd go into more detail, but who cares?
Sure, fighting, crumbling.
All right. So, can I be of assistance, he says, using his wind powers to kind of straighten up the castle again.
Yeah, Feo is here.
Oh.
Yeah,
crap.
This is hers. You need to help. Devereaux, the dude from
Fetacorp,
taking
over.
The
guy who gave me the key to the city last week.
Oh my God, he's
Girl, are you tripping?
No, I'm not tripping. You need to get over yourself. No, he's taking control of my teammate, and everything's going to shit. Everything's falling apart, and you need to help us and not be an asshole about it.
Do you need a popper? You seem like you need a chill.
Oh, my God. For the fourth fucking time, can you just help, please?
Oh, my God. You drama queen. Fine. I'll help.
I'm not the drama queen.
You
here.
Are such a drama queen.
Oh, my God. Don't even.
Oh, my God. You are so lucky you have a cute ass. Otherwise, I would totally drop you.
Stop.
I would drop you right now.
Stop. That's so,
so we've got Breeze
rough.
And Lifesaver, who are like the alpha and the omega.
Oh. Actually, you look down and you see Lifesaver, who's dangling from one foot, but what looks like an air hand, almost. Put me down! I'll put you down when I want to put you down, girl. Stop calling me that! That is not my gender!
I hate both of you! It's almost like, when you go to, like, family reunions.
Oh, it is exactly like a family reunion.
Like, you kind of like your family, but, like, all the rest of your families are fucking weird. There's a couple you like. Like, I really like, I like Ember and Ash when she's not being a bitch.
So
but...
you don't like Ash.
So as much as I hate to interrupt this conversation.
Yes, sorry. Back to the plot. You're
them.
Trying to kill
sorry,
him.
Yes. So if they had stopped and had this long conversation.
Well, okay, so.
You can squeeze a lot of text in panels. You'd be surprised.
I imagine he's like flying back up and having this conversation, and we cut back to the action. So, crackling, about mm-hmm. to explode, mm-hmm. surrounded by Devereaux.
Okay, so I'm going
Where's
to
your
take,
dog?
Do I see that there's a crackling Devereaux, like of Devereaux that seems to be doing some sort of power
move? Yeah, it's crackling pink. Though.
Okay, I want to pick it up by the feet and spin it around Mario style and launch it off of the platform.
So long, Bowser.
I'm sorry, but I'm going to try and roll Salonge Bowser.
Hey, a small, smallio.
Ba-da-da-da-da-da, roll.
4, 5, 6, and it's danger, right? Mm-hmm. So that's 7, 8.
Pick one from the list.
And I will pick 2. I guess I will take something from them. And can I say I'm taking their ability to continue standing on this platform?
I'll allow it.
Yay!
So I should roll then.
Yeah, but remember how last week I made you do that collateral damage roll?
Uh-huh.
I'm gonna need to do a collateral damage roll.
Okay.
Instead of powerful blow.
All right, so just straight, right?
Just straight.
Okay.
Michael, I'm sorry.
This is great. That's a 4, because the Dalek is a 1. Oh boy, I don't like that face.
So mark potential.
Mark potential.
Yay! So that's 5.
What are you gonna do?
Let's get to that in a sec. Let's get through this moment.
Okay, so you land with a thud and you hit your head hard. And gets a buckshot. How far away from the platform are you?
What do you mean?
So basically, I'm going to borrow this real quick. This is the castle. They're up here. Where are you in relation? Like, around here?
I thought I was up there.
Oh, you are up there?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, then you have to roll, take a powerful blow as the thing goes kablooey.
Okay.
Actually, you're going to have to roll this as well.
Okay. Go ahead.
Can I do my never give up, never surrender?
What does that do?
Would he be considered, or would this be considered more powerful than me?
Highly.
Okay. So that is, when you take a powerful blow from someone with far greater power than you, use this move instead of the basic move. Roll plus savior. On a hit, you stand strong and choose one. On a 7-9, marking condition. So you get an opportunity opening against your attacker. You rally from the hit and inspires the team. Add one team to the pool. You keep your attacker's attention.
This doesn't really feel like it qualifies because you're not actively being attacked. You're just caught in a caught in a radius.
That's fine.
I see where you're going with that, though.
I like. Mm-hmm. I respect the enthusiasm.
Mm-hmm. And I take it. So I.
What is that?
Four.
Four. Mm-hmm. Okay.
That's good. Means you.
And then
you
plus didn't. Conditions marked, so it would actually be a two. So. I stand strong.
You should
No, it's add, because remember, high is bad.
Right.
So for take powerful mark, add one. So
oh,
like,
it would still be six.
Yeah. Okay, good. So mark potential. Go ahead, take your potential. And tell me how this explosion does not hurt you.
So it's exploding like the whole thing?
Literally, your friend just went nuclear. So, yeah.
Oh.
Shards are flying everywhere. Thankfully, this thing's made out of mostly water and ice. So it's not like you have to worry about it. Sticking around.
Yeah. I still think that I fall a bit, but I use kind of like my like metal stuff to like, you know, push off the all of the metal that's beneath. And so it's like I don't think I necessarily save myself from falling, but I definitely slow a fall.
Okay.
So I kind of like work it almost like a like a magnet sort of thing, but like repelling magnets.
All right, so you basically use the metal from Kikianistan to sort of like slow your descent?
Just slow my descent, not necessarily keep it, you know.
All right.
Because I don't think I can do anything else.
Well, as you're falling, you manage to, because you're not, you don't have magnetic powers, you have metal powers.
Yeah.
But somehow you manage to find a way to use that and turn them into magnet powers. That's not normal, but it feels right now. And while you slow your descent, you are caught once again by Breeze, who has you in one hand and a lifesaver in the other.
I hate this guy.
That's two now.
He's the fucking worst.
Okay, should I roll to take a powerful blow?
Please do.
I am, however, going to roll. I am not my body, which just means I get to roll with up to two conditions fewer.
Okay.
And if I fail, I have to lose control of my powers in a horrible way, which I think fits very well with my
current predicament.
So, however, I do not fail. That's 5, 6, 7, 8 with no minus. So, I fail, but I don't like fail. I didn't get below 7.
So the bad thing still happens to you. You're taking
didn't
a powerful
get over
blow.
10.
Yeah, that's but you what still I mean. Get something from it.
Yeah. All right. So I still. I'm actually going to struggle past the pain, and gain two conditions.
All right.
Because I feel like I'm kind of like.
All right.
Driven.
I'm
going
to go ahead and tell
powers.
You which ones to mark, okay. though. I want you to mark hopeless and insecure.
Okay. Hopeless, insecure, marked.
Yeah, we're gonna see what happens when you mark all five.
Yeah.
Possibly.
I'm getting close.
As the bomb, for lack of a better term, goes off, the fog seems to fall away, and you see shards and rubble of the tower around you as you, well.
Wait, so I'm not seeing everyone as Devro anymore?
No, everything seems to be cutting back to normal. You're no longer in a green mist. Things are making sense again. You're no longer overcome with this sense of I want to hurt everything. But you are still falling towards the water. You'll see Kid Stardust, who's very unconscious.
I feel like as the castle melted around her, she just kind of...
Is it clear to me that Kid Stardust is the Devro I just was trying to toss off of the building?
Or? No, not yet.
Okay.
Stardust! What's going on? What just happened?
Knocked out, can't say nothing.
Oh, fuck!
Again with the falling!
Oh, fuck.